Thank you. So in my spare time, one of the things that I got into over 20 years ago was combat robotics, which got started around here in the Bay Area about 20 years ago. And it started as an event called Robot Wars in Fort Mason. And pretty early on, one of the things that started shaking out were the types of designs of robots that could be allowed. Because there's a lot of rules, mainly a weight limit that you're working up against. But the real thing that started to come about is like, you know, are you building a spinner, a lifter, a flipper, a puncher, something that cuts? And so the robot that we first built back almost 20 years ago was a robot called Rhino, that where we developed a very powerful pneumatic kind of punching system. And it did pretty well. We were able to get kind of third place. And then there's a TV show that was on Comedy Central back then, and now almost 12 years ago. But when we took that same pneumatic system, instead of trying to leverage off our own robot to turn that system vertically, we could actually start launching other robots up in the air. And so this is a much more successful robot. We won several championships with this robot named Toro back in that TV show. And then the TV show went off the air. And then just this last year, ABC called up and said they wanted to do the show again. And so we started building from scratch once again. And one of our main things that we started learning about new components, how we're going to design now is with really high performance components that have come out of the automotive industry, the electric bike industry. Now there's actual robot controllers like these ones that have a processor on board so that you can do some of the programming that's actually in the computer as much as, or on board the robot as much as the controls that you're doing. Some things that have really changed are things like batteries, these lithium polymer batteries. The old robots we built had 40 pounds of lead acid batteries or NiCad batteries. Now they have 6 pounds of batteries and they have even more better performance. And then some components we had to fabricate ourselves. So we actually had to design and build our own gearboxes in order to get the kind of performance to weight ratio in kind of titanium, steel, and aluminum gearboxes. And the other constraint is that you find out that you're building this robot because it's TV 2 months before the TV show. And so we went straight to CAD, working with a bunch of the cool new Autodesk tools. But we had to design in a way that we could, once we had a design, we could fabricate very fast. So we kind of used this flat pack design of notching everything together, went to laser cut wood. We could just hot glue everything together, put all our components inside the robot, see if it works. We probably built 6 or 7 versions in wood before we went to metal, but those exact same cutting files that we used in wood, we could then put into a water jet machine, and what we were cutting in wood, we're now cutting in aluminum, titanium, very high strength steel like AR-500 steel. And the main constraint that you're always up against in trying to build a battle bot is weight. It's a 250-pound weight class right now, and so at every stage you're trying to trade weight on the inside of the robot for performance in the weapon system or armor. Once you do make it out of metal, you know, the hot glue of the metal world is MIG welding. You can pretty much, once you now are working in this kind of format of water jet to MIG welding, we're able to build bot chassis in literally one day. And then the much slower part comes when you have to cram all the actual robotic stuff in there and make it so that it could perform reasonably. Last year, the robot that we built was a launcher, probably 3 times as powerful as anyone we'd ever built before, called Bronco. And it has 12,000 pounds of lifting force in a 250-pound robot that can exert that force in a little less than 1/100th of a second. So it's very hard robot on itself, in a sense. This is us fighting a robot called Stinger. This was the quarterfinals of last season. Then in the semifinals, we got taken out by a robot called Tombstone with a spinning weapon. To give you an idea of the kind of forces that are involved here, that's 3/8 aluminum that looks like it's torn like paper, and armor grade 38 tie just getting shredded across this robot. So being able to contain the forces and take those forces is really difficult. We just finished filming season 2. This is the new version of Bronco. It has 6 wheels, basically wheels get torn off, so we wanted to have a robot that could, after the wheels got torn off could still keep running. The new season starts, I think, Thursday, June 23rd, and you can see the evolution of robot combat as it comes together now. Thank you very much.